The scene was the second round of the 2012 Stanley Cup playoffs, which pitted two of the best in the West in the St. Louis Blues and the Los Angeles Kings. The Kings were victorious in that series, sweeping the Blues en route to their first ever Stanley Cup. Tonight, the two teams meet again, but under different circumstances, as both are struggling to regain the consistency from a year ago. Live from St. Louis, it's the Blues and Kings, next on Fox Sports Midwest. Well, moments ago, Yara Halak walked off following warm-ups, but is not in the net. Brian Elliott took the ice to start the game, so we can only assume that Yaro re-injured the groin that sidelined him for three games. Our top starting goalie, so Brian Elliott back in goal, looking to turn it around. And Jonathan Bernier, the former first-rounder, gets his first start of the year. He did play against the Ducks back on the 2nd of February and allowed four goals on 21 shots. And there is Halak backing up. And that is a big surprise, to say the least.
This will be a real interesting situation to see how the Blues handle the quick change.
Blues hockey brought to you by Bud Light. It's the sure sign of a good time. Here we go. It's Petrangelo and Cole on defense. Up front, McDonald. Oshien back as a shot on goal by Kopitar, and Elliott makes the save. And we get a whistle.
Well, this would be the best thing for Brian Elliott if there was a surge to begin the game by L.A. As L.A., they will play the game much like the Blues do, and they will funnel pucks towards the net at all angles, looking for a little pass-off pad or catch the goalie cheating off the post. So it'll be imperative for Elliott to be sharp early, but Kirk feels some pucks early could do a great deal for his confidence.
Now the Kings control the face-off. It is Brown, Kopitar, and Gagne up front. And the puck shot back of a goal. Petrangelo in a battle there against Gagne, who did not play in the playoffs, missed the second half of the year with a concussion. And now it's Oshie for the Blues. He'll feed it back to Cole, who played a real strong game on defense against Anaheim. And the Kings in their own zone. Here's Brown to center ice. Andy McDonald chips it back in. Of course, the Kings played yesterday and lost a heartbreaker in Detroit 3-2. The winning goal scored with 4.5 seconds to go after they tied the game with under a minute to go in the game. Now it is Stewart quickly on to center ice, Sobotka. And then chipped in by Pete Ellerby, picked up from Florida last week. As the Blues hold it in, Tolak slides it back on the goal. And Sobotka tied up by Ellerby. Now Bergman works the half boards. He'll chip it back to the corner, and Ellerby again. Run for Justin Williams. And now Williams in some traffic gets away from it. And the Kings to center ice. Handed on to Doughty. No goals on the year for Drew Doughty.
Good hit by Roman Polak, though, making sure Doughty wasn't going any further than the hash marks.
And a centering feed blocked by Steen. And Steen to center ice for Tarasenko. He was bump loser changing. And the puck shot back in. Check Kirk and a foot race gets there quickly. And the Blues work it up the far side. Look out! A big hit! Oh, Tarasenko was hit hard. And now
Wade Redden comes to the defense of Tarasenko with that big hit by
Nolan.
That
was Nolan. And he got Redden down, but Nolan, the son of former NHLer Ted Nolan, he just blasted Tarasenko at center ice.
Looked like it was a good hit, but Wade Redden steps in there, the veteran of 1,002 NHL games. The outlet pass is there. It's a good hit. You can hear the bench calling it. Tarasenko didn't react either. It's shoulder to shoulder. It's a good, clean hit right there. But you've got to love from our Plaza Tire Service replay, Wade Redden steps in. What I like about this fight is that Nolan knows he's got the veteran in a bad spot at the very end of this fight. He stops. That's all she wrote right there. He knew the job of Redden, Redden being the veteran. Nolan knows his job. It's a good, clean hit, good way to start the game. A little scrap. Never hurt anybody to set the tempo of a game.
And yeah, Tarasenko is fine.
That's going to get everybody really on the bench pumped up here too, guys. And yeah, you know what? Tarasenko really, he saw him last minute. You can see out of the corner of his eye, he really didn't get hit that hard.
No, it was a good hit.
Yeah, it was. But he actually missed for the most part. And I like what Red did. Absolutely. That's what you do. You stick together.
We could hear the bench from here with the heads up.
Yeah.
Huh?
Yeah, absolutely.
So fighting majors to Nolan and Redden. As Jackman spins it around the boards, Matt D'Agostini on with Reeves and Nichols. And now Dustin Penner gets it. Penner has been a healthy scratch this year 7 different times. As the Blues get to center.
He's a 2-time Cup champion, so when the chips are on, Dustin Penner plays his best hockey. He was excellent last year for LA in the playoffs.
And number 7, Rob Scuderi up the boards. Now grabbed by Mike Richards. And here come the Kings, 3-on-2. In for Penner. Penner to the front. And that's off point off skate and wide of the goal. Ellerby pitches in. Fires one far side and grabbed by D'Agostini. And now Shattenkirk shots early on, 1-0 for the Kings. In yesterday's loss in Detroit, they had 47 shots. But Jimmy Howard stood on his head.
Yeah, it was the Jimmy Howard show for sure.
Now the Kings get it a drive, tip wide by Kopitar.
This all is because of a bad play inside the blue line by the Blues.
And a drive by Doughty didn't get through. Bounces back for Ellerby, and he fans on it, maybe. He broke his stick, but he keeps the stick, and now the puck to center ice. Whistled back in by Doughty.
Ellerby, a former 10th overall pick by the Florida Panthers. The trade that Dean Lombardi, the GM of LA, made for a 5th rounder.
And a big man at 6'5", 217. Here is Kopitar. He'll chip it ahead for Alex Martinez. Takes a hit from Pollock. Now Williams on the far side. Kings have come out very physical here in the opening period. Now back of line, Drewski is shot. And that hit traffic on the way through. Pollock will brush it back of the goal for Jackman. And Jackman ahead now for McDonald. Rick White feed to Backes. He works in. A drive, and he whistled that one high by the ear of Jonathan Bernier. And now back to center ice. Number 13 is Kyle Clifford to the Blues line. And turning is Jackman. And that's off the corner boards. Comes in front, and Sabotka was in the area, but a good job by Scuderi.
It's like a lacrosse ball coming off the boards right there.
Now Penner ahead. And the Kings. Oh. Lewis got a hit check, and he went down.
Good hit by Shattenkirk. Well timed.
Just got enough of Trevor Lewis. And the Blues back defensively. And Chris Stewart.
Bobby Plager will be liking that one.
And Ellerby, number 5, starts the rush for the Kings. In the scoreless first period, he rings it around the glass. And the Kings in on the forecheck. And they come up with it. Penner feeds it back on the line. Long shot by Voinoff, got through. And it pinballs around in front of the Blues in the right spot. And Steen to center ice.
Good alert play there by Brian Elliott. Didn't get his stick on it, but he flushed his pads down along the ice real quick there.
Well, Steen a shot. That was blocked. Tarasenko after it. But the Kings to center ice. And here's Dwight King. Brother of former Blue DJ King. Down to the line. Scuderi a shot. Tipped. And that goes to the corner. And the Blues after it. Steen trying to clear it. He can't. And then Richard ducks under Pollock's check. And the former Flyer continues to dig in that corner. And then King comes along. Perron knocks it away from Brown. And Steen far side now for Cole. Played over 24 minutes the other night, did he, and Cole was plus one.
Played very, very well. And at the end of the game, Ken Hitchcock gives his little speech about the game, his synopsis, his analysis. At the very end, he made sure to point out that Ian Cole played a heck of a game.
And a wrist shot is right on goal. Elliott makes the save. And we get a whistle.
Well, we've got time now for our Toyota keys to the game. As many fans have just tuned in, expecting Jaro Halak to play. That is not the case. Something happened in warm-up, and we'll get that to you as soon as we can. But our keys to the game are get pucks behind the LA defense. Put pressure on them. And then once you're there, use the points in the offensive zone. That makes it difficult for any team, and the Blues did an excellent job of that in the last game.
And we have a false faceoff. Darren, did this ever happen to you where you were scheduled to back up and the last minute you're thrown in?
No. No, it didn't. Not at the NHL level. There's times where I was supposed to start the game, and I think Mike Keenan made a decision not to play me, so the other guy had to be sharp. But, you know, it sometimes when you're struggling, that type of adrenaline rush and not thinking about it all day can be good for you. This could be a major turning point for Brian Elliott.
And you're paying you, the guys have done a good job so far in front of him now, keeping everything to the outside, because LA has been forechecking really well. yet they only have three shots on goal.
Yep, and there's been some blocked pucks in front that have just gone wide. So you need some breaks along the way, too, when you're starting out a game. Nothing worse than playing well defensively, being sound, and then having a puck go off a stick and, you know, off a body and then in the net.
As Hitch said earlier today, he just wants Elliott to get back to basics, get the technique back, and just stop the puck.
Makes all coaches look better, doesn't it?
Yes, it does. Now Blues to center ice. Backus drops it. Now McDonald flies in there. Here's McDonald, tight angle. Around the goal to Backus. And a shot is patted away by Bernier. Good chance there. And now Backus, who scored in the last game. Far side, Cole pinches in. He'll shoot it back to this side. And now Shattenkirk activates from the right point. But the Kings get it in Kopitar. On to center ice. Here's Brown. Brown trying to run right through Cole. He was knocked down by Cole. And a penalty called against the Blues.
Looked like that was a pretty good one-on-one battle, but the Blues will be shorthanded.
Looks like Cole will go for tripping.
Well, the Blues will be shorthanded. That's certainly going to test the paint job on their face. Oh, jumping at some good stuff there. I thought Braveheart was in the building right there. There's Cole there. He reaches down underneath, and he trips up the legs of Brown before Oshie can retrieve the puck. First power play of the game. Good hard-hitting start to this contest.
Blues have been very disciplined. Only the fifth time they've been short in the last four games. Kings power play not very good. 10.9%, 27. And the Blues after the faceoff, Steen to center ice. And then for Backus. Backus a shot blocked by Doughty. And then it goes behind the goal. Blues on the penalty kill, 75%, which is 25th in the league. And Doughty on to center ice. In for Kopitar. He is nudged by Jackman, and it's fired down the ice by Sobotka. Almost hit the referee. Kelly Sutherland and Brad Meyer, the men in stripes tonight.
That's a good play by Sobotka. He gave Kopitar just a little bit of a whack and hack on the stick, and that caused Kopitar to lose a little handle on the puck and eventually gets turned over.
Now, Jeff Carter caught from behind. And the Blues again clear it down the ice. 50 seconds gone in the power play.
I can just picture Daryl Sutter, the head coach of LA right now, suggesting that the LA Kings maybe get that puck in deep.
And they do carry it in. Roman Polak over there against Stoll. Stoll was knocked down. A penalty called again. And this will be a holding minor.
Everyone's looking around, wondering who it's on. It looks like Jared Stoll is going off. So this puck just absolutely explodes off Stoll's stick. Once he has the entry into the zone, now Daryl Sutter has seen the first three entries not good, the fourth entry not good, and then Stoll takes a bad penalty by having one hand on his stick and reaching around and bringing down the big boy from the Czech Republic, Roman Polak, who has started this game with a good physical hit. I know that's what Roman's looking for, and I know the Blues are certainly looking for that physical edge that Roman brings to the table.
So we go 4-on-4 for 55 seconds in this scoreless first period. Shots 3-2 for the Kings as Andy McDonald digs in for the Blues. McDonald and Backus up front. Richards to center. And then walk along by Boydoff. In with Carter. Boydoff to Carter. An easy tap in, and it's 1-0 on the goal by Carter.
How many times have we seen that backdoor play so difficult for the goaltender? And all eyes will be on Elliott, but, you know, the goaltender likes to think that he's got the puck. He's got the puck carrier, and Voinov has it, and then he just slides it to the back door. I mean, my preference certainly as a goaltender would be to have the goalie take the shooter and make sure that the defenseman or the player coming back take the pass across the backdoor play.
That's a premature slide there, I think, Banger.
Yep.
You know, you can't really make that slide there unless you know that you're sliding actually toward the guy that's making the pass. If he slides more toward Voinov, Voinov can't make that pass, but Voinov made a pretty good play there to jump up on the play after Richard. Richards was knocked down there by the pinching Redden, so pretty good play by Voinov.
Voinov's had a heck of a start again. He played in the American Hockey League to start the year, and that has paid off. He has been sharp all season long for them. Real bright spot.
Carter's first in three games, fifth of the year. And it's 1-0 LA. Now they steal it back of the goal. Here is Dustin Brown. Brown to the front, a shot, and Elliott fought it off. And it's grabbed by Steen. Voinoff and Richards get the assist on that goal. Still 4-on-4. Now Cole is out of the box, and the Blues do get a power play for a minute. And Carter's shot turned away by Elliott. Blues power play is red hot. Goals in five straight. They were 2-for-2 the other night and lead the league over 36%. On to center ice, McDonald. And then tipped in deep, McDonald trying to get there. Clearing attempt right in front and a shot by Berglund. Or rather, Tarasenko was off the shoulder of Bernier and out of play.
Tarasenko held to only one shot in his last two games. After having five shots in the opener against the Red Wings, it's certainly going to be challenging because teams know how quick his stick is, how good he is in small areas of the ice. But there he rifles one off the right shoulder of Bernier, trying to go high to the short side.
And 37 left in the Blues power play. It is McDonald, Stewart, and Tarasenko up front. Kings jump into a hole and pick it up, and here comes Carter up the ice, but slowed up by Shattenkirk.
Good feat by Shattenkirk right there. Carter can be a pretty tricky player. Got a great shot.
Now Steen on to center, Tarasenko up the middle. That's blocked by the Kings' Clifford, and off the glass and back down the ice. Blues have not scored in 38 attempts, including playoffs, against the Kings. Well, that is a drought, to say the least. And the Kings ice it again. And that will just about do it, with Stoll set to return, and no shots in the power play.
That first forechecker of the LA Kings is really on the Blues. They go as far down as the goal line to put some pressure on the D.
Now back is then Sobotka. They work it in. Bonnie Sobotka stops to Jackman. And he'll fire it all the way around the end boards. Oshie nice hooks play. It back to Pollock. And his drive was off a shin pad in front. Now Pollock gets it again. Wrist shot. Tipped by Backes to the corner. And then Oshie over there. Oshie through his legs. Now controls it back for Pollock. Pollock, a wrist shot. Got through. And Bernier juggles that a bit, but now covers with the Blues sniffing around that goal crease area. 9-11 to go, first period. The Kings on a Carter goal lead it 1-0.
Well, there's one of the toughest players that's ever played, the former Blue Tony Twist, and he's got a good buddy of his right there. He's feeding him a little food. That's little Alex, the 7-year-old, and Alex has really been battling some cancer, and we just want to wish Alex the very, very best. He's just such a great Blues fan, and great to see he and Twister there. Twister's got him taken care of, huh, John Kelly?
Oh, he's in good hands.
He's in good hands right there.
Absolutely. Yeah.
Twister had him down in the locker room before the game, stopped by to say hello, too. That's a wonderful thing for Twister, and what a wonderful young little man there.
And Alex, I think, had a little speech for the boys, a little motivational speech, and why wouldn't you listen to a 7-year-old little boy that's battling such an awful disease?
Well, our prayers are with Alex.
You got it.
Hopefully he enjoys the game, and hopefully a Blues win tonight. Now it is Stewart back to the Blues. Shot 6-5 to the Kings. They lead on the goal by Carter at 8:31. And Sobotka chips one to center. Now picked up by Berglund, and the puck bounced on him, and that put the play offside.
Well, the Blues have got to find a way now to get the puck across the blue line and establish what they did in the first 12 minutes against Anaheim. And hard to do. L.A. plays a real tough game. Certainly they've struggled scoring goals, unlike the Blues. But they defend well. They played a heck of a game. I think they're feeding off the game that they played yesterday at Joe Louis Arena, which was as sound as I've personally seen, especially going into that building. But the Blues have not tested Jonathan Bernier whatsoever. And for a guy that hasn't played at all this year, except in relief on February 1st.
And now Kopitar stops the puck in the corner. He meets up with the Blues captain. Backes goes down. Kopitar trying to work it free. Back for Doughty. Doughty a drive. Oh, that was wide. Comes in front and right to the goal crease as Brown almost had Gagne open on the far side. Three on two.
Across the board.
Yes, it did. 3-on-2 Blues. Petrangelo to the front, and Gagne got back to break it up, or McDonald would have had a great chance. And now McDonald knocked down Petrangelo. He'll pry it free. And then on the cycle intended for McDonald, Kings get it back, and here is Gagne. And then Richards. LRB number 5 trying to work it away. Up the middle. That goes by Tarasenko. And now Jackson, the Kings almost got caught on a change as Perron walks into the front. And Tarasenko with a great chance. And a save by Bernier.
Did it go off the pipe?
It may have. What a chance there. Now Tarasenko, who was set up by Perron. Tarasenko trying to get free. Off the boards. And the Kings have the right coverage, and Tarasenko can't get a shot. And now Lewis, he'll filter one of the corner. Pollock bumps Dustin Penner. And then fed back on the goal for Lewis. Wrapped up in knots by Jackman. And now stolen Perron, fight for it. And David Perron off the board, now to Pollock. And he goes for a skate back in his own zone. Under seven to play in the first period. Scott Nickel on the ice. To center ice. He's turned away. And then Pollock will feed it back for Shattenkirk. On the wing to Nickel. Trying to fight through that Drewiski check. And then Reeves down low along with Nickel. Chip to the line to Shattenkirk. Winds and fires. That was wide by a foot or so. And now Clifford for the Kings gets into center ice, and Carter sidesteps Reeves. Here's Carter one-on-one. And on the back check, Redden knocked it away. And the Kings hold it in. Carter wide open. Tipped off the crossbar, I believe, by Clifford. And now Clifford back on the goal. Now in front a shot. Hit a body. And then Carter trying to go to the line. He does for Scuderi. And then Jeff Carter again. Low shot. Missed the goal. In comes Clifford. And then to Williams. Knocked out of midair by Scott Nickel. Held in Scuderi. A drive. Blocked by D'Agostini. And then Nickel back on the goal for Redden. And the Blues slow it down.
Two breaks, one on either side. Perron makes a great play to Tarasenko, and I thought that one might have gone off the bar, or maybe a great save by Bernier. We're not sure yet.
I think it was bar too, Painter. At least it appeared from this angle, too. I got a little bit of glass in my way, but I think it was off the bar.
And then the one on Elliott, a big break with a little redirection in front, nibbles off the crossbar.
And this will be an icing call against the Blues.
Good rush there by the Blues with David Perron going down the right side. I thought that maybe he ran out of real estate on this play to Tarasenko. Here, our Plaza Tire Service replay. Fake shot, buttery little pass, right on the tape, and there's cleanly off the bar and out. Then it comes the other way, and the LA Kings get a good scoring chance off a redirection there. Redirection, stick, crossbar, and Clifford can't get to the rebound. Clifford's had a heck of a start for the LA Kings.
6 points in 10 games, and he leads them in the hits department. So the Kings up by one. Nolan can't get to the front. And now it's Cole. Behind the Blues, goal ahead for McDonald. Quickly on to Backes. Here's Backes, trying to feed one through for Oshie. Oshie on Ellerby. Now played to the far side, and Nolan with it to the Kings, and he'll swat it away. And then Petrangelo for Oshie. And that backhand feed is picked up by the Kings' Voinov and sends it in. Shots remain 6-5 for L.A. Up by one late here in the first period. Blues trying to snap a four-game winless streak. Long pass for Sobotka. Trying to step around Doughty. He does. And then Sobotka can't get through Drewiski. And then Berglund comes in. Takes Davis Drewiski to the far side. And then four players battle for it. Blues get it. Berglund trying to work off the boards. Back on the line. Jackman, a drive. Not throw. Here's Stewart. He was knocked down but gets up quickly. And then Stewart with some time on the cycle. But Doughty gets it back, and it's off the leg of Jackman out of the zone.
Too bad. Just a mistiming on that reverse. That's a heck of a shift by Sobotka. He battled off Doughty, kept the puck in deep. By the time Stewart gave him the reverse little cycle, he was already out of that area.
And the Blues dump it in around the board. Shattenkirk kept it in there. A long shot block. And now handled by Andre Kopitar, their first round pick in 05. And that's chopped in deep by Brown. Shattenkirk takes the hit from Dustin Penner. And now quickly on to Perron. Nice feed to center. Tarasenko drops it off for Steen. And that goes deep. And Voinov is turning for Los Angeles. What a rookie year he had last year. Now the Blues to center. Break it up. Perron trying to step around Voinov. Careful not to wrap him up. Woynoff goes down.
His skate came up real close to David Perron's face.
Yes, it did. Now Perron in traffic to the slot for McDonald, but he was too closely covered. And the Kings to center ice. And will that be an icing call? It will, as Stoll was on his own side of center ice. Bon Jovi returns to Scott Trade Center on March 13th with their Because We Can tour. Tickets on sale now at the Ford box office or any Ticketmaster outlet.
Love Bon Jovi. Little guy, too. Look at that little guy.
You know, we met him in Peoria when we were in training camp, probably in the, mid-80s.
Who's going to face off? Ole and Cole went to shoot it, then was having to backtrack as Lewis comes in. And Lewis
dragged it to the middle of the ice and create a better angle. The puck rolled off his blade.
And now Petrangelo scoops one to the far corner, near corner rather. Carter comes in. And broken up by Reeves. Ellerby puts it back in, a crazy hop off the glass, now controlled by the Blues, and Petrangelo. His feed to center ice. And then D'Agostini gets it deep. He's after it, takes out Ellerby. Kings up the middle, that's cut off by Nickel. Good forecheck there, now for D'Agostini back of the cage. Trying to get free. Kings play one to the left wing side for Drew Whiskey. Just got by Reeves and back to center. There's Jackman. He'll rip it right back in.
Good hit there by Ryan Reeves, making sure he got just a piece of Drew Whiskey.
Under two to play. The shots remain at 6-5. I think we have been shotless here for a good 5 minutes. As the Blues get it in, Doughty. Having a tough year, no goals, and minus 10 on the year for Drew Doughty. But he is a terrific, terrific player. And now Nolan to center ice. Jordan Nolan plays it deep. Here's Shattenkirk. Look out. Big King is after him. And now it's on the boards and back as they hit, and he'll get a penalty.
On Nolan, who's a hit from behind.
And they will call it an elbow on David Backes.
Nolan was somewhat going down, so tough play for David Backes right there. Well, David Backes goes to the penalty box, and he didn't like the call. He tried to have a conversation. I talked to David the other day about some of the physicalities around the game, but we'll take us to our first bank first take, and it's about Kopitar. Four goals, team lead. He's a Slovenian, and the good news, talking to him today, the country is qualified for the 14 Olympics. His father coaches. His brother is also a player on the national team. So that's big. His brother Gaspar, really good player, younger than Anche.
Kings 0 for 1 tonight. Now Kopitar walks it in, sends it all the way around the inboards for Richards. Crazy hop from the corner. Jackman gets it. His clearing attempt hit Carter. And now play to the line, but Doughty could not hold it in. In the final minute of the opening period. And Mike Richards back. Dustin Brown leads the Kings with three power play goals. He's on right wing. A shot by Richards. Tip to the corner. Blues player lost his stick. That was Shattenkirk. Now he retrieves it. And Brown feeds Kopitar. And then back to Brown. Tip by the Blues. Great read by Oshie. And that knocks it onto center ice.
That's why Oshie's so relied upon on the penalty kill. Just so intelligent. Great stick angle there. Anticipates the play.
Now the Kings working around 25 to go in the period. And Drew Whiskey cannot hold it in. Kings have to regroup. Doughty drops it off. And here is Drew Whiskey, signed as a free agent. Worked into the zone. And then Stoll drops it. Blues have three men on the far boards. Now they stole it. Kings in front. Wide open Drew Whiskey. And Elliott got a piece of that with his arm. And that went to the far corner.
That's a big save by Elliott to end the period. Big save right there. I thought that play was offside. Before LA entered the zone, but regardless, it's a quick play, a quick pass by Stoll right on the tape, and a wonderful glove save to keep this just a 1-0 hockey game. Here's the pass by Jared Stoll, right to Drewski, going high to the glove, bang, right off, oh, jeepers, right off the mask, side of the face right there, and a good one as it just slides past the glove side, And no harm done after that.
Shots on goal in the first period.
Carter has the only goal. And the Kings lead by one. Let's shuffle over to Pat Parris.
John Kelly, thank you very much. 1-0 after 20 minutes of play. The Blues are trailing the Kings here at Scott Trade Center. And coming up on the St. Paul GM Country Intermission Report, we'll tell you what's on tap for the Blues. Bernie Federico will make his way up from the bench to join me up here in the Bud Light Zone. But right now, let's go downstairs because I believe Chris Stewart is standing by to talk with us. And Chris, obviously you guys came out on the ice and it wasn't Yaroslav Halak like we all expected, but Brian Elliott in net. What was going through you guys' minds when Yaro wasn't able to go?
You know, it's obviously a tough bounce, but we're comfortable with whoever who's in the pipes there, and you know, it's out of our control. And you know, that's the thing about groin injuries. You know, you can tweak them at any time, and hopefully have them back soon.
Got to, I guess, tip your cap to the LA Kings. Are playing a pretty good road game. Very physical game so far. How are you seeing it?
Yeah, we knew what we were getting ourselves into. You know, we knew they're a big team that likes to play physical, and we knew it was going to be a big challenge. And, you know, we just got to stay out of the box, and we'll be fine.
You guys played a pretty good game the other night, although it was a shootout loss. I know you guys took it hard. What are you taking into this game? What can you take into the second period in order to kind of build on it, Chris, and you know, get a couple of goals, get this lead?
Yeah, that wasn't the result we wanted the other night. And, you know, when you don't play 60 minutes in this league, it's going to be hard to beat 2 points. But, you know, we snuck it out of there with one. And, you know, it's a process, and we took some steps in the right direction. And, you know, like I said, you know, we got a big game here tonight. And, you know, we got 40 minutes left to get the dub.
Well, good luck in the second period, Chris, coming off that goal and 2 assists in the last game. Get a couple more and get a victory for the Blues. Thanks, Chris. That's Chris Stewart of the Blues. We're going to bring you the St. Paul GM Country Intermission Report right after this. Blues trail 1-0, outshot 7-5 in that period, but still 40 minutes of regulation to play. Stay with us on Fox Sports Midwest.
Goal by Carter, 1-0 Kings after 20 minutes of play. John and Darren back in the broadcast booth. Well, Yaro Halak was supposed to be the starter, of course, missing 3 games with the groin. And, Darren, we can only assume that he re-injured that groin. And Elliott throwing a curveball in warm-up.
No question about it. But often when you don't have to think, you don't have to worry about what happened, you can park everything that happened in the last few games aside. It's one of those emergency situations. You get your gear on, and all of a sudden the adrenaline takes over. I thought Elliott played a real strong period, made that big save on Jurisky late with 2 seconds left in the period. Otherwise, it's a 2-0 LA Kings lead, but instead he makes that save, and that could be the difference in the game. I mean, I would expect, we've heard nothing from the Blues whatsoever on this, but you would expect with the road trip coming up that old Jake Allen, who just went down, is going to have to get his gear ready and possibly come back up here.
Blues hockey is brought to you by Bud Light. It's a sure sign of a good time. Here we go. And 35 to go in the Bacchus Minor. So the Kings on the power play to begin the second period with some fresh ice. Carter tips it in. Now play back of the goal for Brown, on for Kopitar. Doughty slides it across to Richards. Blake Richards back for Kopitar. Doughty a shot. Sobotka blocked that. Lost his stick though. And the puck chipped in front. And now Nickel diving. Can't get it out. Richards gets it. Sobotka no stick. And a drive and a blocker saved by Elliott. And then knocked into midair by Nickel, but not out of the zone.
Good save right there with a stick.
And now Doughty. Kopitar. Backus out of the box. Kopitar shot. Hit traffic. And in the slot, now knocked to the corner. And the Kings and Kopitar again. Sobotka can't get a stick because it's broken. He can't pick it up. Only a goalie can play with a broken stick. And Nickel off the glass and out. And that goes out of play, and that's a break for the Blues as they were down essentially a player on that shorthanded situation.
Well, you talk about leaving your feet, too. After this happens here by Sobotka, he slides trying to get it. Now watch Nickel, number 12. Nickel's going to sprawl around as well there. Everyone's leaving their feet, just trying to get the puck out of play to try to help the fact out that Sobotka doesn't have a stick. What a save that is. And excuse me, I thought it was with his stick. It's right with his blocker. Good positioning there by Brian Elliott, finding the puck through traffic and making a real good, solid save.
And off the faceoff, Williams gets it for the Kings. Trying to shoot around Bacchus. And then Redden steps up. Here's Oshie to center ice and Backes. He'll play one to the corner, and then is hit by Clifford. And the puck play to the near side.
Clifford came across from the weak side and took away all time and space from Backes, and a good hit to nullify Backes from getting it. We'll keep our eye on Backes. That was a good hit.
Now the Kings up the ice. Lewis drops it. Clifford had it broken up. McDonald feeds it back. And then Redden, long feed to center ice for Steen. And Alex Steen. He'll dump it in, go off on a line change. And Voinoff gets it for the Kings. Long pass goes through the middle. And this should be an icing call as Petrangelo goes back and we get the whistle.
Well, you talk about backside pressure. It's one of the things that the Blues and the LA Kings do so well, and that's how they defend their net. They don't give up too much time and space. Here's the flip-in play. Stop it here now. The flip-in play's there, but watch Clifford come in with a lot of speed, helping his defense, and bang! Good shoulder-to-shoulder hockey hit right there, and then the LA Kings are able to get it out of the zone.
Well, that's great play because Kadri can't touch back because it's a penalty. So it's always nice to have your winger coming back to help.
We're going to have a new name for that. It's called strong side, backside pressure to help the little chip-in play.
Yeah, I like it. can you put that in just the letters?
I'll text it to you.
Blues win the face-off, Stewart. And now for Berglund. He wins the battle back of the goal. Here's Berglund in front and a backhander on goal and a save by Bernier. And now grab by Scuderi. On for Stoll. He works to the corner. Ian Cole back there. Good job now for Petrangelo. And the Blues to center ice. Sobotka. And then D'Agostini. But Drewiski turns out of the corner for the Kings. And chipped to center ice by Stoll. That's King after it against Pollock. A couple of big boys there. Back of the goal. Jackman has some time. And his feed to center ice intended for Tarasenko. That goes all the way down. And as Ellerby touches up, we get the icing call.
Well, for Ken Hitchcock and the St. Louis Blues, they're facing off against the former head coach. And when Ken Hitchcock took over for the Blues, Doug Armstrong had to make a difficult decision. They let go a good young coach in Davis Payne. They felt they had that opportunity to get Ken Hitchcock, maybe before Hitchcock went somewhere else. There were plenty of rumors about that. But it's good to see Davis Payne back here. He's a good man, and I know all the members over at Meadowbrook Country Club really missed Davis. He was a member there, and he and his wife and family and reined themselves into the St. Louis community. So good to see the big guys. Living about a couple of blocks from the beach.
Very nice.
And I know you miss taking his money off him and playing in those Thursday games, Banger. So you bet on that.
I wasn't even going to say that.
I know you weren't.
Here's Doughty, a shot. And it's on goal and a save by Elliott. And then he controls that rebound.
Did Backes tip that in front of our net?
Yes, he did.
Oh, my. That makes it dangerous right there. I used to try to tell your players in front of you, if you're going to get it all. There's the shot, and right under the blade. And that's why Elliott was, watch his stick position. It's going to go to his right, but then now the puck comes back high and hot just at the pads, just because of the little redirection there from Backes. Backes a little soured himself, so he gives a little whack right there.
Yeah, you don't want to get your stick anywhere, Banger. What would you be saying to him right now?
I would
have in goal.
I probably would have gone and gave him a whack myself. Say, get your twig out of the way.
Let me see it and get out of the way.
Kings control the faceoff. Clifford back of the goal, but now Petrangelo up on the far side for Perron. He'll deal one on for Tarasenko. Slowed up by Ellerby. Shots in the second period, 3-1 for the Kings. And 10-6 for the game for the visitors.
Another big hit by Clifford.
Now Carter behind the defense, and he scores! Carter got behind the defense, and he scores his second tonight.
The big fella really got going with that first stride. It looked like it was going to be an innocent enough play, and Carter just put on the jets. This little pass over to the right, and he gets beyond Cole, forehand, backhand, and through the legs. He gets Elliott here to open up the legs with the forehand, the backhand, and right between the wickets there. A goal scorer's goal by Carter, and Elliott can't get that stick down flush on the ice quick enough.
His team leading sixth of the year. And the Kings have a 2-0 lead. picked up last year from Columbus for Jack Johnson and a first rounder. Chopped away by Reeves. And then Nickel feeds it back. And now handled by Jackman. And his dump it. Nickel after it against Drewiski. Hope back of a goal. Reeves in the area. And now Lewis has it. Lewis turning. Can't get it by big guy Reeves. Pollock in from the right point. And his shot blocked. Comes back to Jackman. A shot. Got through and a save by Bernier.
Carter.
And now Nickel again. He feeds D'Agostini.
Boy, that's a minor penalty there on the back. Doughty used his stick, kind of a subtle cross-check along the back, the lower back, and knocked D'Agostini down. Smart play by Doughty. Got away with one.
Ellerby gets the only assist on Carter's second tonight at 3:23. Now the Kings, who lead by two. It's Scuderi. And then for Richards, he'll chop it back of the goal and go off in a line change. And Jackman slows it down. Long pass to center. That's intended for Sobotka. He missed it. And icing called.
Let's go back to the goal that was scored there. Besides the nice little move by Carter, we'll stop it there. This is the collision that I'm talking about. Now we're going to see Carter get up the ice on the right-hand side. And this pass here is a beauty by Ellerby. Over the stick, it looks like Cole is in good position. It's a saucer pass about 3 feet off the ice. So he doesn't whack it out of midair, and it lands right perfectly on the tape to Carter.
Now the Blues work it down the ice. And Chris Stewart in a race against Voinov. And then shot the other way by Scuderi. And they rule that Redden could get there in time. He does. 5 minutes gone in the second. Here the Blues to center ice. Oshie was checked. And now Oshie back in his own zone. He'll feed it across. And Redden scoops it up the middle. That's picked off by Gagne. And he is belted. Good hit by Oshie.
That'll get things started. That's a good hit. Good clean hit there, and Gagne goes for a change.
And the Blues shoot it down the ice. No ice in here. That's reversed by Voinov, played by Ellerby. And then Clifford to center ice. He's run down by Backes. The
Blues are going to have to pick up that physicality.
Stolen by the Kings, and Williams a drive. That was blocked. Clifford to the corner, takes out his man. Now it's back of the goal, and Williams, two-time Cup winner, one with Carolina. And a shot got through by Doughty and a save by Brian Elliott. And then scooped along by McDonald. And Ellerby turning away from Backes. Kings up the middle. That's blocked. Oh, Petrangelo lost his footing. But there's Cole to center now for McDonald. There's no room in the neutral zone at this point. And then Williams back in. He goes to the backhand. Feeds it in front. Knocked away by Elliott. And now Cole has it. And he's got some time and space. Nice pass to center, Perron, now to McDonald. And they enter the zone to the corner for Perron. And his pass picked off on the slot.
It is one and done for the Blues. They cannot get any sustained pressure against the Los Angeles Kings in this game. There's no cycle. There's no playing it back to the point.
And now Scuderi fell down, but Steen couldn't find the puck. Now back of the goal. Here's
guys,
Steen.
A lot of guys blowing tires out here, huh?
Yeah, a
having
few have.
A little trouble with the ice.
And the Kings up the ice. Nolan, he gets it down low for King. Hit hard by Pollock. A lot of size on this line. Stoll, King, and Nolan.
Big beef on the bun on the backside, too, though, with Roman Pollock and Jackman together defensively.
Tarasenko can't get in there. Under 13 to play here in the second. That's wide of the goal, and icing called against Los Angeles.
I would agree with you, Panger, that there's been no sustained pressure. There is a lot of big bodies on this team, and the Kings, I think Daryl Sutter's been able to roll all four lines that have all size on them. And right now, that's been really the difference in the game, is the size of the Kings not allowing the Blues to get any pressure in the offensive zone.
Yeah, Stoll is between the two big redwood trees right now, Nolan and Dwight King. Remember, it was Dwight King last year that the controversial play injuring Petrangelo in game one with that hit push behind the net.
And the Kings swept the Blues. It was their first ever sweep in their history.
They had a heck of a run.
They led every series 3-0. Won 10 straight on the road, which is an NHL record. As Nolan gets it in deep. Goal there. He'll fire one back of the goal. Stewart now for Redden. And Redden's pass. Headed for Sobotka. That goes wide. Bernier, in his first start of the year, sets it up. And it's off Gagne's skate to center. Pump back in by Redden. But the truth is, the Blues have not really tested Bernier at all. Only six shots combined in the first and second period.
That's what the most surprising aspect of this game has been, that not been able to get their game going offensively.
You know, Darren, it almost looks like the Blues were rattled after the late change in goal. I mean, we're only assuming things here, but that they just have played a rather tentative game, and Yanolak was supposed to start. And now it's Oshie up the middle. Here's Oshie. Pass back to Petrangelo. And a save. There was a great chance for Petrangelo, and a save by Bernier.
Petrangelo can't believe it. He's got his head looking to the skies right there. Perfect play. Right-hand shot on the left side. But Carter's got his second of the game.
Having to change the goalie before the game started, did that change the psyche of your hockey club at all?
No. He's played fine. We're not creating enough. We're not winning enough board battles. They're on top of their game. They're playing very hard. They're playing very well. We just got to catch a break. Like the last play there, we got to make sure that we've got people coming up in the rush. And the few chances both teams are giving up, we're going to have to find one to get back in the game.
Thanks, Hitch.
Yeah, there was the best chance perhaps of the game for the Blues.
Great chance right there, and it almost looked like Petrangelo just pulled that a little bit. If that fades off to high glove, because the goaltender's coming towards him, and that's where there's probably the most amount of room.
Now the Blues enter the zone. D'Agostini far side for Perron. Kings get back to break it up. And it's Trevor Lewis. That shot. Hit a leg, goes to the corner.
D'Agostini replaces Tarasenko on this line.
And now the Kings, they work down low. Mike Richards, the former Flyer, now for Penner. But the Blues get it back, and Petrangelo for Ian Cole. Uh-oh, look out. He lost it. Kings in front, and a shot by Carter. Oh. And he may have broken his stick looking for the hat trick.
That's where he's at his strongest, too, with that quick release and wicked wrister. Big break for the Blues there.
And now Petrangelo on for D'Agostini. And that's lobbed away. Shot 12-7 for the Kings in the game, who lead on a pair of Jeff Carter goals. Here's Clifford around wide. That shot stopped by Elliott in front. Another drive by Scuderi, and he whistled that one wide.
Elliott lost sight of it.
And then a shot by Williams right on goal, and a save by Elliott. Kings are really putting on a push here. Already up by two. And the puck in the slot. D'Agostini is there. Can't clear it. Carter shot. Backhander. Pinballs around in the goal crease, and it's covered by Elliott. And now we have a scrap. D'Agostini drops the mitts.
Elliott razor sharp. I'm going to give Brian an awful lot of credit. Had a conversation with this morning after the skate. This guy's worked his tail off at the skate. He knows he's trying to find it. He knows he's battling. He was scrambling in practice just trying to keep everything out of the net. I tell you what, he's had a heck of a hockey game keeping the Blues in this one.
That is D'Agostini in the box. Midway through the second. Matching Miners Kings up 2-0. A special guest in the booth trying to get the Blues going here. The great Joe Buck has joined us here tonight.
I don't know about the great part, but we need something to kind of shake this thing up a little bit. What's going on?
Well, here's what happens, Joe. You come up to the booth here, and they get some momentum. You stay here. That's the way it's going to be. You're not leaving. Because we're looking at anything we can to get some momentum back for the Blues.
Okay, good. I feel good about that.
Of course, Joe's late dad, the great Jack Buck, was the original voice of the Blues in the first year, along with Jay Randolph, and your dad called the first ever Blues goal.
And he used to joke that he knew nothing about the sport or the players, just would focus on one guy, and that guy would have the game of his life that night.
Red Berenson, what a game.
Wow. Even when he was on the bench, Berenson was doing something.
Did he enjoy doing hockey?
No, he loved it. And he loved watching it. I mean, he and I used to sit at home watching these games night after night, living and dying with your dad calling the action and watching really every move they made.
We would love you to call a Blues goal.
Come on. That's like moving heaven and earth right now. But
you know the Blues. You're a season ticket holder.
I know the Blues. I don't know the other team.
Scoring or are you calling it?
Both.
I'm sure you can handle it.
Yeah. Okay. Well, if you're waiting for me to start, I'll go right now. The guy wearing number 5 for the Kings behind the net will bring it out. Get it to center ice, and Kopitar, who wears number 11, back to that number 5, Ellerby, I believe. Tips it into the Blues end, and now Shattenkirk trying to dig it out of the corner, back behind the net. Elliott looking out to his right and out of the point. Voinov, who gets it down low, and now Petrangelo will get it out of the Blues end, and Tarasenko, let the kid do something. 91, light up this crowd as Petrangelo in the corner tries to make something happen for St. Louis. Given up to L.A., and now back out of the Kings end to center ice and into the Blues zone by Voinov again. That guy's everywhere. That's going to be my guy, Voinov.
Yep, Voinov will be your
whoever
guy.
That is.
He's
Petrangelo.
A good player.
Okay, good. Here's Steen bringing it into the King's end, and now a shot by Oshie, but turned aside by Bernier. Is that who's their goaltender?
Bernier with a really good stick save.
Good. I mean, help me out, Pang, for God's sake.
Well, he's a French-Canadian man, Jonathan Bernier.
I don't care where he's from. Just give me his name. Here's Doughty at the point. Shoots, and it's going to be off a stick and out of play.
See,
the faceoff will be in the Blues zone.
Your calmness in transition is excellent. And
yeah.
I think that was one of the best scoring chances that the Blues had in a little while.
Yeah, well,
thanks to you being up here.
My heart is pounding. I mean, I've done all these. This is, you've got it. I might do some Cardinal games this year, so you guys have to come and help me out.
That's awesome news.
As long as Tim Garcia says it's okay.
Our floor director up here.
There's Red Berenson. Boy, did he have some nights when my dad was calling the action.
Did he ever, huh?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Absolutely. John, you can hop in whenever you want. I have no idea what I'm doing.
I'm going to go get some popcorn, Joe, so okay. You're doing great, and you've got a great future at this. So.
Yeah, okay. Here's a shot that's wide, and this is 71.
Nolan.
Yeah. Nolan. It's not Owen Nolan, though, is it?
It's not Owen Nolan.
No.
Remember Teddy Nolan, the head coach?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's his son.
Oh, brilliant. I'm old enough for that. Doughty at the point, and a save by Elliott. Caught it in the mitt there, Panger. That's like you used to do back with the Blackhawks.
You know,
back in the day.
In baseball, there's very few screens for a guy. But that was a screenshot, and you can see the way he had to kind of fight it off and still track it. And I will say this, and you've seen in your day covering any sport, when a guy's struggling, it's no fun. It's no fun to call it. You feel bad for the guy. Brian Elliott's one of the great guys. University of Wisconsin kid, worked his way to a scholarship. And the last few games haven't been good, but boy, he's been good in this game.
Yeah, well, they need him to be right now because he's facing a lot of adversity, a lot of shots.
Yeah, because if anything happens to him, it's either Corey Hirsch or me going down there and playing. Yeah, so.
Corey, Jake Allen's on line one. He'd like to talk to you.
Jake Allen could be in the car coming here right now.
Is he not here? Where'd he go? Where's Halak? I thought Halak was playing.
Halak's on the bench.
Well, what's happened?
Well, he obviously hurt himself. We're speculating, but the only reason why he's not playing is because he obviously hurt himself in the warm-up again. He left the warm-up on time. Everything was normal. We're doing our open, talking about Halak coming back and playing. We started off, we get no word because nobody knows what's happening in the bench, except for Ray Birilli, of course, the flying trainer for the Blues. And then, bang. Brian Elliott's in the twine to start the game.
Meanwhile, Roman Polak has gone off for some sort of penalty. He did something he was not supposed to do, John.
And the Kings are 0 for 2 tonight, Joe. Another power play.
All right, so here's Carter bringing it out with Kopitar in the middle over to left wing. And here is a goal scored by 44.
Drew Whiskey.
That means I'm out. I mean, I come up here for 5 minutes, it's 3-0, and it's more of the same from the last three nights. So I clearly bring no mojo to the party here.
Well, the minor penalty, Roman Polak not happy with the call whatsoever. And now he goes to the bench. There's no way they've ever changed a goal in my lifetime or a call. But regardless of it, it ends up being a nice pass by Dustin Brown right to Davis Drewiski. And Drewiski, another Wisconsin boy. He just fires it home right there with a wicked little wrister. It goes off the post and in. Carter's on the doorstep. Kopitar's on the doorstep, and it looks like maybe Halak's leaning towards his right, trying to find it. It whips by his glove on the left.
Elliott. That's Elliott.
Well, what would I say?
You said Halak.
Now, see, I'm all baffled now.
Yeah, I know. All right. I'm going to get out of here before this thing gets out of hand.
I might go get some whiskey from Drew Whiskey.
Good. There's that Panger laugh that I listen to. There's nothing more mesmerizing than a Darren Pang laugh. Here's Elliott that just has to cover up. And I'll say this for Elliott. He's not getting any breaks either. It goes off the post. It goes in instead of going off to the side.
Yeah, you're right. We were talking about that earlier in the game because there's a few that went off the crossbar and went off a stick, and I thought maybe this changes and he does get some breaks. Maybe the hockey gods are going to help him out a little bit. But this has not been easy for the Blues because they somewhat tentative in this game, getting on their toes and going forward. They haven't generated anything against Bernier. Your call was the most dangerous scoring chance. And that's it.
But here's the deal. You're really good at what you do because I couldn't do that. I would be broke and walking the streets if I had to do this for my living.
What is your favorite sport, by the way?
My favorite sport to watch is right here. This is the only season ticket that I buy, but my favorite sport to call is probably baseball. It's fun. It's got a great pace to it. I love it.
This pace here can get hectic in a hurry.
Yeah, that's the fun of it, though.
Yeah.
Hey, go ahead. When I'm at home and you guys aren't doing the play-by-play, it drives me nuts. So, John, you do it. Goodbye. Love you. I'll be watching. And if my seats are empty in the next 10 minutes, then don't focus on them.
You got it, buddy.
All right.
Good seeing
you.
Joe,
thank you very much for coming up. It was fun. All right. Do we say this is St. Louis Blues hockey?
Yes.
Hey, this is St. Louis Blues hockey.
Drewski got that last goal from Brown and Kopitar. 3-0 Kings. Let's go downstairs between the benches for this Bomberito Automotive update.
You know, the Blues have got a lot of effort. In fact, when you look at this last power play goal, the Blues really give up a 3-on-2 here, and then everybody's chasing. Look, everybody's coming back. No one's watching the late guy. Drewski comes right in the middle of the slot. He gets the puck. Carter's got the screen, and bingo, it's in the net. So it's not lack of effort right now, but it seems the Blues are chasing the game, which we keep talking about, and they've just got to settle down and play their own game, get it deep and forecheck.
As Backes flips it in behind the King goal. And it comes around to Clifford. Look out, buried on a hit by Andy McDonald. And a penalty called, I think, on that hit.
They're calling a boarding call on Andy McDonald here.
Yes, they are.
Clifford's going to go over there right here and say something to Andy McDonald. The much smaller McDonald on the big... Clifford's had a couple of big hits in this game. And now David Backes takes exception to Clifford. Something needs to get stirred up in this game. It doesn't mean taking a couple of bad penalties, but the emotion's got to get high. Pollock and Backes frustrated with some of the calls that have been made in this game. Clifford, though, has played. He's played a good game in terms of his physicality. And from the angle that I saw originally, you can see the angle that McDonald ends up taking. And he's trying to take an angle and come in on a good angle and thinking that he's got the side of Clifford.
So a power play for the Kings. 1-for-3 on the night. And the shot's now 17-8 for Los Angeles. We're in the faceoff, Petrangelo. Off of Carter, now moved along by Nickel. Here's Nickel, shorthanded. He comes in, a shot, and a body save by Bernier. He juggles it a bit, and no further play.
Bernier comes into this game amongst all active goalies with the lowest career road goals against average, 2.15. From the outside like this, it's a routine save for a goaltender, but the key is he handles the rebound. And Sobey goes in, and again, like Sobey always goes in, he has a collision, hits somebody or somebody hits him, and he never goes down.
Hitchcock had Bernier as his goalie a couple of years ago in the World Championships. He said he began the tournament as the number two goalie for the Canadiens and ended up number one. He really likes Bernier, does Hitchcock.
With James Reimer of the Toronto Maple Leafs, that was the tandem, and Reimer started, but Bernier, the former first-round draft pick, who went 11th overall in 2006, interference
Los
call
Angeles
is going to be on Dustin
number
Brown.
23, 2 minutes for interference.
Remember that big hit that Dustin Brown had last year in Phoenix in the conference finals? All he's trying to do is get the line. He's trying to hold the line and stay onside. And as he's doing so, he collides with Steen. Those are tough calls, too, though, aren't they, Bernie?
Yeah, they are.
They are, because you know, he's just trying to stay onside.
Yeah, I mean, if this is a 0-0 game, there's no call there. But it's right now 3-0, so I think that's a break to the Blues, because you can see clearly that Brown was not trying to interfere with Steen. He was just actually putting on the brakes.
So we go 4-on-4 for about 90 seconds. And that is kept in by Petrangelo. And now Patrick Berglund takes a point off. Wide open for Petrangelo. And then Shattenkirk a shot. Oh, drill saved by Bernier. And then Berglund or Oshie had the rebound attempt.
Good sequence right there going D to D.
And Shattenkirk will go back for the Blues. And then Boynoff tips it back of the goal. Berglund trying to get it away from Richards. Kicks it on to Oshie. And then Richards again. With 4:20 left in the second period, the Blues down by 3. They need something to get them going. Here's Lewis at center ice. Hit by Shattenkirk. Now Steen across for Petrangelo. Into the zone. Good pass. And Steen comes in. Here's Steen trying to get in front. Forced to the corner by Doughty. And now out high again. It's Petrangelo back behind the goal for Backes. And then Backes with some speed. To the line. Good keep in by Pollock. And Roman Pollock stops. Looking to make a play, and look out, Lewis all over him. And Pollock has to retreat to center ice. And then Williams has it for the Kings. Bodied off the puck by Backes. He'll play it back to Pollock. He works in. Wrist shot, missed the goal. And then kicked by Sobotka. And then back of the goal, here's Perron again. And then the Blues get McDonald back. So now they're on a power play, second in the game. Here's McDonald. Back for Shattenkirk. Wide open. Shot blocked. Pinballs around in front, and it was a hand pass.
Yeah, it went off the glove of Sobotka. Even though he had two hands on his stick, it went off the back of his glove. And doesn't matter in that situation whether it's your palm or not, but it clearly goes off the glove of McDonald right over there to Sobotka. So Sobotka doesn't see that. Well, we certainly have some social media questions out there. We know we've got lots of them. Is it to JK Hockey? Is it, do you have a question for us? Tweet your questions at FS Midwest. We'll get to them. Make it a brilliant one.
Well, you've got to have it. Long live the note.
Yeah, you have to have that. Otherwise, you're not in play.
And the Kings are now back at full strength. So the brief power play is history. Under 3 to play here in the second period. And then Kopitar taken up by Petrangelo. Now Kopitar gets free. Worked over by Petrangelo, and then finally Stewart there to break it up for the Blues. Blues on the road after tonight. A three-game trip starting Wednesday in Detroit. And it's Stewart. Getting knocked down by Gagne. Here is Voinov. Up ahead for Kopitar to center ice. The Kings have played only 3 games at home this year here, and they will play 11 of their first 15 on the road. Talk about a tough schedule to start.
Yeah, very, very difficult. Grammys were in L.A. for Daryl Sutter's club. They're always there at that time. Daryl signed an extension. They brought in Davis Payne, Jamie Compon, the former Blues assistant, end up leaving L.A. and going to Chicago, so a little bit of change there. But anytime you start, you know, on the road, you win the Stanley Cup, you go through a lockout, not easy, but the one bottom line for the L.A. Kings, they're not going to be out of this. They're not going to be out because they got a core group of guys that have won.
Oh, a shot by Backes on a one-timer from the slot, just wide, kept in by Pollock.
Blues have changed their game.
Yeah, they have picked up the intensity really for the first time tonight. And now it's Perron clearing the zone. Oshie back in.
What a pass.
To Backes! And that was knocked away by the goaltender, Bernier.
What a pass by Oshie. Man, oh man.
Jackman, a glove pass here. But they rule the Kings player touch it, so yep. Play continued.
Yeah, you see what Backes and Perron, they knew that it was gloved ahead by Jackman, so they didn't touch the puck.
And the Kings are back. Here comes Ellerbe. On the center ice. He'll scoop it back of the goal. Pollock. And King in on the forecheck. There's Dwight King with 70 seconds left in the second period. And then King rolls it back of the Blues goal. There's Jackman ahead for Vladimir Tarasenko. Pass on to center. That's rifled in by Steen. Comes around. Then Sobotka.
He was boarded, but no call. And Sobotka drops the miss.
Yeah, he's going to take it upon himself.
That was Lewis. And he lands a couple of rights.
How do you not love this guy? Hey, the spunk and the fire that he plays with. You know, maybe he turned and spun at the last second, but he got hit from behind. And instead of looking at somebody else to take care of it, Vladdy Sobotka takes care of it himself. And that's why he's endeared himself to the fans here in St. Louis and his teammates. Lewis, the former first rounder there. You see Sobotka's in a bad spot, and he gets hit on the numbers by Lewis. Well, Lewis obviously thinks he's going one way, and Sobotka stops and turns, but Sobotka had enough.
Yeah, I'm real surprised too. Yeah, he did turn to the boards, but that's where you have to stop your hit. And I can't believe that one of the referees didn't get their hand up, because I thought for sure that we'd get a boarding call, because we've already had three boarding calls tonight. That surprises me that there was no original call.
Well, you know, funny things have happened in this game. I mean, you can go back to the very first part of the game when Clifford had that big hit on Tarasenko and Wade Redden stepped in. And really initiated a fight, and Redden has a visor, which is a 2 minute extra, and that wasn't called, an instigator wasn't called, and then some of the boarding calls that have taken place. I mean, referees are aware that these two teams go at it tooth and nail every time they play, but there have been some funny ones in this game as far as I'm concerned.
And the Kings have picked up the extra minor.
So did they get the boarding call originally? I didn't see an arm up on that.
I did not either, unless it was the guy over on this side where I can't see down the bench, because clearly the guy that I'm looking at across. Yeah.
It was a boarding minor.
Because I was watching the referee. I think Sutherland was right across from me, and his arm didn't go up. He was closer to the play, so the only way it would have to be is that maybe Meyer called it from over here to my right where I didn't see him.
Yeah, no, and I watched him. I did not see his arm go up. Have to have an LA player in the box. 45 seconds remaining in the second period. 2 minute power play. Boy, would it be huge for the Blues to get one late here.
Blues 0-2 tonight. Shaq Kirk across the sky. And they got one late.
Holy jumping, what a rocket. Did he get everything on that? Wow. No chance for Bernier whatsoever. That thing sprung off his stick. Good play by Shattenkirk. Controls it, gets it flat. Good face-off win by McDonald. To Steen. Steen then peels off and just rifles this one under the bar and in. Traffic in front by Stewart is the key. Net front presence, timing of the shot, and the Blues are back in it.
And a shot by Perron. That was tipped off the glass. 35 to go in the period. Held in by Backes. To Oshie. Big save by Bernier. Oh, what a chance there for Oshie.
Mark that one down. What a response by Bernier off a quick one-timer.
And now Shattenkirk back to get it. 20 to go in the second period. Blues have now scored power play goals in six straight. Here's Oshie again. Oh, to Backes behind the defense. And the puck was just a bit too hot to handle. Well, Backes, that's another penalty call. As Scuderi knocked Backes down.
Well, it'd be beneficial to the Blues not to retaliate here. Clifford's come in there and trying to get TJ Oshie to retaliate, but Oshie didn't do it, and that's a smart move. We've got another opportunity to regain some momentum. A boarding call is going to be called on the LA Kings. David Backes facing the boards. Gets hit by Scuderi. Big, strong, defensive-minded defenseman. He's won two Stanley Cups, one in Pitt and one in LA last year. Look at the visor of David Backes. It has come crumbling down. So Backes is right here. He fanned on the pass originally. And so by fanning on the pass, it looked like he was just going to go that way to his right. He fans on it so it stays to his left. By that time, Scuderi has a pretty good feel that Backes is facing the boards like he is.
7 minutes for boarding.
And a minor for boarding, and the Blues go back on the power play with 4.3 seconds left. Backes is going to the Blues locker room. The Blues goal, Steen from Shattenkirk and McDonald at 19-17.
And whenever there's a boarding call, if there is facial blood anywhere, then it is a five-minute major. It's not an option. It's not a, we can call it a two. No. If it's a boarding call, which they call boarding, and there is blood, then it's an automatic five.
Blues win the faceoff. A shot by Petrangelo goes wide after David Perron, who doesn't take many draws, won that faceoff.
It
was shot wide.
And John, excuse me, and I will clarify that. There's no confirmation that there was blood, but I saw Alex Petrangelo having a conversation with the referee, so imagine that might have been what it was all about there. But this pace is picked up. The last five or six shift for the Blues really got things going, and they get rewarded with a power play goal.
Blues have been outshot 17-12, trail by two. Over to Pat Parris.
Guys, thank you, and I will say the Blues have picked up their play. Indeed, they have, and they'll continue the third period on the power play. They just got the one power play goal by Alexander Steen, his second goal of the season, and so the Blues are back in this one, trailing 3-1 after 40 minutes of play. Coming up on the Jack in the Box intermission report, Bernie Federico will come up from between the benches to join me in the Bud Light Zone. We'll have Bernie's breakdown, also our dirt cheap shot of the game, and our Ford game summary as well. Blues with a little work to do, obviously, in the third period, but certainly right back in this hockey game. And we'll be right back with the Jack in the Box intermission report. Blues and Kings, a physical battle right now. The Kings have the edge by two goals with 20 minutes to play in regulation. Stay with us on Fox Sports Midwest.
After two, the Kings with a 3-1 lead over the Blues. And the Blues will have a power play to start this third period, Darren Pang.
Yeah, and we're joined by assistant coach Ray Bennett down below before he's the eye in the sky here for the third period. And Ray, is it safe to say that you gained some confidence and momentum in the last 8 or 9 minutes of that period?
Yeah, for sure. I think there's a couple things that lead to that. Sobey standing up for himself in the fight, getting the power play and the goal are an obvious thing. But, after that, too, we had some chances to generate the next power play for us, too.
You start the power play with fresh ice. Do we make too much of a deal of that? Or is it going to be a factor here to begin the third?
Well, I'm not sure it's too big a deal or not. What it is for us is it's a big deal. And we have to come with the mindset that this is our opportunity to close it to within one with lots of time left. And that's, good ice, bad ice, that's the situation we're in.
Ray, good luck in the third. Thanks for joining us.
Good, thank you.
All right, that is assistant coach Ray Bennett. And we are set for the third period. By the way, McDonald's assist on that Steen goal was the 300th of his NHL career.
Now we go to the heavy hitters of this game, the two captains, two great American players, Dustin Brown and David Backes. Dustin's played a little bit more than Backes has. He's on in the penalty box a couple times, but now we'll see if Backes returns. He got that big hit there that resulted in this power play. And looking at the bench down below, I don't see him on the bench.
As the Blues work it in back on the line to Steen, a shot, and that was blocked. And now we get a report that he is on the bench. That is good news. Shattenkirk off the board for Tarasenko. And then Voinov pounds it around. Bounces back to Steen. Long shot, and that goes wide. And then Stewart. Here's Shattenkirk dancing in. Pass back on the goal. Stewart trying to recover. And then Shattenkirk again.
Someone's
stick broke. That's a King player.
Yep.
And a shot by Stewart. Blocked by Voinov. And that goes out of play. And that's a big break for the Kings.
That's too bad. I'm not sure if Chris Stewart was aware of the fact that the defenseman of the LA Kings had a broken stick. There's David Backes. So my mistake. I wasn't sure if he was on the bench or not after that hit that he took in the ending parts of the period by Scuderi, but here's no stick, and now with Andy McDonald open on the point and the LA Kings reeling, Stewart puts it off the skate and out of play.
And the Blues in their top-rated power play go to work here. Kopitar steals it, but now has it pilfered by Perron and kept in. Good job by Perron. But the Kings have it, and Carter, who has scored two goals on four shots, shoots it all the way down the ice.
And I think what has made the power play unit successful is the healthy competition between the two units. Two distinctly different units. One an umbrella, one's kind of an overload power play, which this one is right here.
Now Berglund around the boards. Here is Backes. And the captain gets it back with a goal. Berglund, who has scored three power play goals. Back for Oshie. Rifles one to Backes. Now they try the other side. Perron for Petrangelo. Return feed. Now Petrangelo again. He moves in. A shot. Hit a leg. Never got through.
Good play by Clifford. He got in and blocked the shot.
And then Backes pries it free. Here's Petrangelo again. Now in for Oshie. Little slap pass to Perron, but that was tipped way high. And they will bring the faceoff to center ice.
You know, even if it goes off David Perron's stick to the goalie, it's still so far away. We've seen the Sedins master this play, the half shot, half pass to the middle, but it ends up being so far away. I'm not sure if this would be a dangerous chance right there. You see that it doesn't pick up much steam in that play. What it would do is maybe create a little bit of a rebound in front, or with traffic, it'd swat it out of midair, tip it on the way. But on its own, I don't think it has enough to get in.
No, you need a lot more power on a shot like that one by McDonald. That went wide. As the Blues get it back to Redden. Late in the power play. Steen off the wall.
Where is it?
And Voinoff blocked it. And Simone Gagné, former first-rounder by the Flyers. And ahead. Blues penalty. Their power play has expired. Scuderi's out. The Blues did not get a shot on the power play.
Yeah, that's an opportunity gone awry there after the great end to that second period. Now they got to get her going at even strength here.
And a shot by Brown wide of the goal. The Kings this year win leading after to a record of 4-1-1. The Blues win trailing are 2-3-1. It is Ellerby back. And around for Brown. Captain trying to clear it. Kept in by Poloff. Far side now for Perron. Ellerby gets the stick in the way, but Perron motors on. For Poloff, a shot and a save by Bernier as Poloff had a decent chance.
That's a good read by Roman Poloff there. That's going to be icing right now, so play will come back to Jonathan Bernier's left. Bernier just made an outstanding save with Roman Poloff on the strong side, coming in from the point. He gets an awful lot on it. Watch 46 in the blue. Here's big Roman. Sees the play developing. Perron gives him the pass, and it's a good, hard shot. The rebound actually comes right back to him. Look at how this rebound springs off the blocker, off the side of his body, and then just jumps right out in front. Good play there by Roman.
There was some room under the blocker there, wasn't there?
Uh-huh.
Ooh, wow.
Yep, it was a good choice. I think that was a good save there.
And now the Kings clear it ahead. But McDonald gets it back quickly up to Boris Barroshi. And Voinoff under some pressure from McDonald, who stole it. But the Kings are able to get it back to center ice.
A relentless pursuit of the puck there by Andy McDonald. And he stays with that terrific young defenseman there.
The Blues and Steen. He has scored their goal. Good job to hold it in. And Steen gets it back at the goal, but Rob Scuderi there. Side is a free agent. Center ice. And look how Penner has it. He's got a lane in front. And Stoll could not get it.
Good play by D'Agostini. He came back hard to help out Petrangelo.
Now in front, Stoll. He scores! Stoll, one-timer. No chance for Elliott, and the Kings take a 4-1 lead.
Well, after D'Agostini comes back hard, the puck had jumped over the stick of Petrangelo just in outside the blue line, and it looked there like the LA Kings, with Penner having the puck, was going to be in good shape. There's where it comes over the stick. There's Penner. He's kind of on the offensive side of it, makes the pass. Good play there by D'Agostini. And then right after that, it looks like Penner's going to go over to the Scuderi. Instead, he drops it back to the man coming off the bench, it looks like. Or was that Voinoff?
Right-hand that was Voinoff, shot. Yeah.
It was Voinoff that slides in the strong side and plays it right to the right-handed Stola, just rips it to the open side of the net. A lot of east-west goals being scored against the Blues in their own zone. Just a lot of that dot-to-dot pass that the Blues are so good normally at defending against, and just not quite sharp and aware of that pass.
Well, Voinoff's made two good plays tonight, Banger. On the first goal to Carter was a great pass, and same one here. That was heads-up plays coming in from the point. I mean, he's an offensive guy. He wants to go, and he's made some great plays.
That was Nolan and David Perron doing some fencing before the face-off. And the goal by Stoll is first in four games, second of the year. And now Stewart comes over and has words with Nolan. And the Kings lead 4-1. The goal by Stoll at 3:36.
Assisted by number 26, Slavin.
And Boydoff with the great pass. As the Blues come in, Pollock in front, knocked away by the Kings. A shot by Berglund wide. Here's Pollock. And out high, he plays one of the corner penalty coming up here.
Doughty's arguing this one here. David Perron got in the kitchen of Drew Doughty, and I think he rattled around a few pans because Doughty looks like he's getting a retaliatory slash on this play. Right in the back of the leg. Doughty gets him with a two-hander. And just before that, you see Nolan and Perron there. But Stewart comes in there, and it looks like Nolan's trying to lure him into dropping the gloves early, kind of fake like he was going to put down the gloves. Nothing happens. But from that point on, Stewart was moving his feet as fast as I've seen him move those wheels in this game. He was chasing all over the ice.
Stewart challenged him, Banger. Stewart came right over and challenged Nolan, and Nolan wanted no part of it. He said, let's go right now, and you can see the smile on Nolan with a 4-1 lead. He said, not a chance.
Yeah, so, you know, you're right. He's probably right. Not the time to do it.
It was 1-for-4 tonight. As Tarasenko gets it back to Steen across. Kattenkirk couldn't handle it. Kings have it, can't clear it. That was McDonald on the keep in. And now Voinov steps up, and it's swatted down the ice. And the Blues have to go back in their own zone. Again, four forwards on the ice for the Blues on this power play. Led by Steen, who has scored their goal tonight. Steen drops it. Here's Tarasenko. He walks in, and a save by Bernier. Tarasenko didn't get a lot on the shot. Then covered by Bernier.
Maybe that one extra move going back to his left. What makes Tarasenko such a threat is how he can change the angle. Whether it's a goalie or defenseman, he leans one way, gets them to bite. They go against the grain, he goes the other way. And there, he doesn't get everything on that shot. It kind of slides under his blade. Easy save there for Bernier. Sobotka and Lewis come out of the box. The fans and the bench of the Blues giving Sobotka a tap on the boards. And that's exactly what Ray Bennett said. Just sticking up for yourself. You don't need somebody else to do it. If you don't like the hit, go take care of it yourself. And that's the spirit that Sobotka brings to the table every night.
Now Berglund wins the faceoff. Back for Pietrangelo. Into Oshie. Thought about shooting. And then Pietrangelo again. Far side Perron. Backus screens in front. Now to Backus near the net. That went through his legs. Shot around by the Kings and kept in by Oshie.
And Blues have got to just move that puck quick. The puck's going to go a lot faster than anybody else. You're trying to get the penalty kill unit to lean toward one side or cheat toward one side. And then really, that's when you've got to move that puck quick.
Well, quick pass in for Oshie. He works in. And that shot block gets his own rebound. And a pad save by Bernier. Blues get it back to Pietrangelo. 40 left in the power play. A drive and it got through. And a save by Bernier after Richards has lost a stick.
Pietrangelo has a couple of options right there. He can go to his left or with David Backus, and at the end of the shift and putting it on the line in front of the net, he puts it towards the net. Here's the backhand attempt. Good left pad save. Perfect butterfly right there by Bernier. And there's the last play. Pietrangelo's quickly become one of the very best defensemen in the league at getting the puck through. Carlson in Ottawa is spectacular with that little snapshot. It always finds its way through. Shattenkirk's good. Doughty's good. Not easy to get it through there, but Pietrangelo always seems to change the angle enough that it doesn't get blocked.
You know what, though? With Richards having no stick, again, that's the second time that the Blues didn't take advantage of a player with no stick or even with a broken stick. And, I mean, Pietrangelo's got Richards right in front of him with no stick, and that's, I'd rather see a little give-and-go, Banger.
Yep.
Give it to the guy and then go step by Richards.
Now McDonald wins the faceoff. Back for Steen, a shot. And that was well wide. Shattenkirk. He'll play one low, shot around by Ellerby, and the Blues can't hold it in. And they have to regroup with 22 to go in the power play. In down by three goals. Shattenkirk, what a pass to Stewart. Almost got behind the defense, now Stewart. In behind the cage, Ellerby rides him out. Andy McDonald comes over to help out. But the Kings break it up, and the Captain Brown gets it off the boards and out. Blues had three shots in that power play. And Doughty is back on the ice. And it's to the corner now for Tarasenko. The Kings are there, and the easy play by Carter to lift it high all the way down will result in the icing call.
Carter thinks this went off the stick of Tarasenko before going all the way down the ice, trying to plead his case, but that's not the situation. LA cannot make a change. Tarasenko's learning about some of the big bodies in this league. The LA Kings play it hard, north, south, up and down the wing, kind of an old school the way that they play.
And the faceoff won by Carter. He has scored two tonight for the Kings. Gruwiski and Stoll the others.
Oh.
And the Blues do a good job of holding in. Reeves a drive and a stick save by Bernier. What a hit far side by Sobotka. And they whack away on the far board. Sobotka along with Nickel. Back for Scuderi to his partner Voinov. And that's lobbed ahead. Redden plays it. Now it comes back to Pollock. And behind the back to Redden. And the Blues are in the midst of a change. And now Redden walks it on to center ice. His pass tipped by Nickel all the way down. Kings in a defense mode now, up by three. Richards to center. In for Nolan. Nolan now to King. These two kids were called up late last year, and boy, did they give the Kings some great work down the stretch into the playoffs.
They were exceptional. Jared Stoll was their centerman throughout the playoffs, and they were an exceptional line. And now Mike Richards is the pivot between the two.
And a drop pass blocked by Oshie. On the center ice, it's McDonald. He was rattled by Doughty, who had a huge hit last night in Detroit on Datsyuk.
And his job on that play was not allowing Andy McDonald to get the line, and he took it away from him there with a good hit.
12-12 to go here in the third period.
Tough sledding here. The Blues just got to put everything at the net and see what they can get out of it.
And a shot wide of the goal by Berglund. Tapped in deep by Oshie. And then Berglund wins the battle. Back for Pollock. Pollock, a long bouncer, blocked in front by Scuderi. And it's off the boards and out. And then Jackman trying to get it back in, intended for Perron. But the Kings in the right defensive posture, and they play it in. This should be an icing call as Pollock gets there first.
Well, we mentioned Drew Doughty and what kind of a hitter he is. He's obviously a good offensive player and not getting the kind of offense this year. But this is in yesterday afternoon's NBC game. I mean, how many times do you see Datsyuk get hit like that? He's aware of everybody on the ice. And defensively, Doughty came across, knocked the lid right off of Datsyuk. Here in this game, he's taken away the line. Those are the keys. You're playing the clock, you're taking away the line. You don't want the opposition to get there. But that hit up on Datsyuk, I was watching it going, holy, who was that? And where did he come from?
And then Datsyuk gets right up.
Now and not only does he get right up, he doesn't complain about the hit one bit. He gets up, he gets his lid. He ends up scoring a beautiful goal in the game as well right after that.
Now the Blues off the faceoff. Back in Tarasenko. In for Sobotka. Chopped away by Drewski, but Shattenkirk in for the point. Here's Shattenkirk at the front. Backhander. And a save by Bernier, and he gets the mitt down to cover up. 11:20 left, third period. Kings with a 4-1 lead.
Time for a Bomberito Automotive Sports Update. We look at the other scores from around the league, and you see Columbus, they score 43 seconds into the game against San Jose and add five more to win 6-2. Phoenix took a 1-0 lead, but Colorado's come back with two goals in the second period, lead 2-1, and no score between the Wild and the Flames in Calgary. J.K. Panger, Hall of Famer, back to you.
Thank you, Pat. Shots dead even at 18-18. Blues get the faceoff. Oshie a shot. And a stick goes to the corner. And then kept in by Shattenkirk. And now Doughty around the board. There's Petrangelo again. Oshie knocked down, but keeps on working against Kopitar. And then knocked away, and then back is caught behind the play with Oshie. Here are the Kings. 4-on-3. Gagne into the zone. And getting back to break it up was McDonald. But now Brown gets it for the Kings. And Brown, their captain for Kopitar. And he was upended. Good job by Oshie. Shattenkirk on his knees, scoops it ahead. And Petrangelo will wind it back in the zone. Shots this period, 6-1 for the Blues. But the Kings have scored on their only shot. Stolen down low by Perron. One centering pass blocked. Now gets it again. It hit his chest, I believe, and it goes to the Kings. And Voinoff, little flip pass ahead to Carter. And a race here. Pollock, and he beats Carter to it. And we get a whistle.
Well, Oshie went awkwardly into the boards on his last shift. And it wasn't like it was anything violent or anything like that, but it's a little push. It's a good battle there with Kopitar. Now watch, Ellerbe there goes in. It kind of collapses his left knee. And by collapsing his left knee, with whatever push that, the head and neck of Oshie goes right into the boards. You see how dangerous and how fragile your neck can be. And that's why in USA Hockey stresses when you have a chance to go into the boards like that. You try to get your head up as quickly as you can. And then, I don't know, that seems odd because you're going to take it right in the teeth, but you don't want to put your head down as it compresses your neck.
Now Redden rolls it back to the King goal. Bernier thought about going up the left wing. Now they work it to the far side. Carter quickly on to Clifford. And Kyle Clifford off the boards and in. And a big hit back of the goal. Cole goes down. He gets up. And the puck is grabbed by Redden. Good pass. Look out. Tarasenko stripped at the line by Ellerbe. And now Tarasenko on the back check with a good play.
He didn't like that. He didn't see Ellerbe there behind him. Caught him by surprise.
And the play goes offside. 9:26 to go, and the Blues down by 3 goals here in the third period.
Well, keeping the puck out of the net has been a challenge for many teams in this lockout shortened season. Many goaltenders didn't go overseas, and you take a look at Ken Hitchcock. He's always had some tremendous defensive clubs, including the Jennings Trophy last year. But from January to February, it's been a plus 3.25 goals against per game for Daryl Sutter in L.A., plus 1.25 per game. They've tightened up the hatches here in this one, only giving up one and only giving up 18 shots on the road in back-to-back games. That's pretty solid defensive hockey by the L.A. Kings.
But as we know, the Blues entering the game had allowed 22 goals in their last four. Hitchcock said he went through the same type of thing when Columbus made the playoffs back in 09 with Steve Mason.
Yep.
He said they were just out of sorts. Mason had lost his confidence, but they just fought through it and got out of it. And that's what the Blues are going to have to do. There's a rebound attempt, and King had a good chance and a save by Brian Elliott.
The key is to keep plugging away here. Keep showing resolve. Keep playing hard. It's right to the whistle. You get one, you never know what can happen, but if as a hockey club, you just pack it in, that is dangerous and alarming. And I don't see the Blues in packing this in. I think they still think they've got enough time here to get back into this hockey game, which they do.
Yeah, pull back for the Blues for Pollock. Again, Pollock was supposed to start the game, but apparently re-injured the groin in the warm-up. And Elliott, the starter tonight. And the Blues do stay onside. Here's a shot by Oshie right on goal, and a save by Bernier. Let's head down between the benches for this Bomberito Automotive update.
Well, I just want to reiterate what you guys are talking about. I mean, this team has got to stick together, and they've got to do the simple things. I think what we're seeing is everybody is trying way too hard to drive things that they shouldn't be doing. I mean, it's just the simple plays. I mean, David Perron trying to go all the way across instead of just going up the board or just skating with it. But that's easy for the LA Kings coming back. They're going to be able to pick those passes off. But you got to get the legs moving, and good things happen when you continue to work hard, guys.
And in an offensive zone faceoff, the St. Louis Blues coaching staff put on two offensive-minded defensemen. So you got Petrangelo and Shattenkirk there trying to climb back into this game. An old scene, and Bernie, you're playing the clock now.
Yep.
Down by 3 with 8 minutes to go. It is full-on pinching. It is a relentless pursuit of the puck and finishing your checks.
And the puck kept in by Petrangelo. Nice feed to D'Agostini. Oh, what a pass! Wide open nickel, but he couldn't handle it.
What a great play right there. Wow.
That was a beautiful feed by D'Agostini. And now Reeves on the far side. Checked. Comes ahead for Gagne. Here's Simone Gagne. Nobody open. Plays it back on the goal. Now grabbed by Kopitar. who is held up by D'Agostini and poked ahead for Nickel off the boards and out. And then it is Doughty back for Drewiski. Shots 8-3 for the Blues in the third, but they're down by three. Quickly on to center. It's Sobotka. In for Tarasenko in front. It rolled off his stick, and it's covered by Bernier.
Nifty little backhand saucer pass by Sobotka, but it doesn't get all the way on the tape. So Tarasenko gives him a little tap on the pads. This is the play before. It looks like D'Agostini's going to fire it, and you see Nickel, he's getting himself set up, and it just goes off the heel of his stick. Must have taken his eyes off that puck for just a fraction of a second, and that's all it takes. And it was a firm pass by D'Agostini, and the blade wasn't firmly on the ice by Nickel.
And Carter wins the faceoff from Sobotka. Kings played up the boards to Clifford. And Clifford now on for Doughty. And that pass goes all the way down. Elliott tees it up for Bear Jackman. And now Redden comes over. Or rather was Redden, not Jackman. And now Cole gets it on the center. Sobotka by a man. Into the zone with Tarasenko, and he can't get it over there.
What a play by Voinov, the defenseman. Wow, did he do a good job of tangling up Sobotka.
And then shuffled in there by Clifford. Redden goes back and plays it for Cole. With under seven to play in regulation time. Long pass too far for Perron. And handled by Scuderi. Up on the wing now for Dwight King. Who goes 6-3, 2:35. And the Blues go back. And again, Perron, Redden, on to center ice for Stewart. Stewart in a slot to Berglund. His pass to the left wing, but Perron was not there. And the Kings off the boards and out. Now Stewart again. Can't get it by Doughty to his partner Scuderi. And then back for Doughty. Lewis for Richards. That's tipped into the Blue zone. And Chatterkirk up the middle, look out, Oshie. Ooh, slowed up there by Stoll.
Good communication still on the bench. Again, you could hear it from here by the Blues bench. Tell him the heads up.
I was going to yell, too. I could see him coming.
Well, they work it on to Oshie. At the King line. Ellerby got in front of him. Backer's trying to follow up. And then Oshie tied up in knots. And the Kings, good job defensively. Lewis shuffles it back down the ice. And then Petrangelo now for McDonald. And then back of the goal. Blues begin a three-game road trip Wednesday in Detroit against the suddenly red-hot Red Wings.
He's not the best player in the game. He's very close to it, and that would be Pavel Datsyuk, and he's caught fire the last couple of games. They're both afternoon games against Edmonton and against the LA Kings on back-to-back days. And he was the best player on the ice by far on both of them.
As Pollock reverses for Jackman. And off the glass now for D'Agostini. To center ice. Reeves in the area. And he gets it in deep. Played by Scuderi.
Going to be a penalty coming up here.
It's against the Blues. As Williams feeds it in there. And that's touched by Pollock. And a roughing minor has been detected. With 4:31 to go, it's against Reeves.
Well, for Brian Elliott, the surprise starter with Halak getting injured in warm-up. I always found these to be the toughest plays, getting your right pad on the ice quickly. Both goals by Carter underneath the pad of Brian Elliott. The deke, forehand, backhand, and again underneath him. Not being able to get that right pad down, sealed to the ice. Those frustrated me to no end. Pucks that went underneath me. And I'm sure Brian feels the same way.
And when things are going good, Panger, you probably got that pad down every time, though. And when things are tough,
And in saying that too, Bernie, sorry to cut. He's really made some good saves. I think there's some foundation for Brian to work on and some positive stuff that he's done in this game.
Absolutely. This is basically thrown into the pressure cooker because he thought, he worked hard, extra stopping shots this morning.
Yep.
Working on extra things, angles and everything, and all of a sudden now he's thrown back into it. So it's a tough night for him, and I agree that he's played He's played okay.
Yeah, the defensively, the East-West goals are something we're not used to seeing from the broadcast booth, and you from ice level.
Yeah.
I mean, the Jarrett Stoll goal is a perfect example of normally the stick position, the angles that the Blues have in their own zone. They don't allow those one-timers from there. And basically, pretty easy goal.
Here comes Nolan. He goes wide. Kings 1-for-4 tonight. They work it back now on to Ellerby. And that's blocked by Backes. Kattenkirk tried to clear him. Kept in by Ellerby. And then Mike Richards down the board. Nolan across. Now Boyd off in front to Richards. Little backhander, and he doesn't pull the trigger. And then back for Ellerby. And Ellerby, good job to hold it in. I don't know what Richards was waiting for to shoot that puck. And the Blues clear it.
The only thing I can think of is he ended up too far over to his backhand, and he was looking. He's a great passer on the backhand, and I think that's what makes Richards such an effective player, forehand and backhand. And I think he might have been looking to go to the high slot.
Yeah, he was looking for Nolan.
Yep.
And a shot off the back of the goal. Jackman with it off the glass, and that goes down the ice. Under 10 to go in the Reeves penalty. 2:35 left in regulation. And barring a miracle comeback, the Blues will be winless in 5. And the Blues are back at full strength. As Doughty fires a tip toward the goal. And now Scuderi gets it. That goes back of the goal. And now picked up by Pietrangelo. So a very disappointing homestand. It looks like the Blues will get 1 point out of a possible 8 on this 4-game homestand.
Very, very discouraging. You don't circle that on your calendar and say that's what's going to take place.
And Gagne a drive. Good pass saved by Elliott. Blocked down by Berglund. And then ahead for Perron. He goes wide. Swinging in front. That was blocked. Now Perron again. Gets away from Voinov. He'll get it back on the line to Shattenkirk. On to Cole. A drive. It got through. And Bernier made the body save.
Well, Cole drove it to the net. Now we're going to take a look at our Mazda drive to the net. And it was a howitzer. Power play late in the second period at 19:17. This is an absolute rocket. A perfect shot off a face-off win by Andy McDonald. Pushed back to Steen. Steen pushes it to Shattenkirk. And then Steen gets in an open position for a well-executed power play goal.
And then the Blues had a power play late in that second, early third, didn't get a shot on goal.
That's a key point of the hockey game. Key point, not being able to execute and prepare for it to begin. It could make it a 3-2 hockey game. Instead, they don't, and Stoll scores shortly after that at 3:36.
And that was on their first shot, and from then on, the Blues have been bottled up. Here comes Tarasenko with Steen. 1:10 to go here. Tarasenko to the front. Trying to make a pass to Pollock. Now grabbed by McDonald. But tough sledding through the slot. And the Kings lob it high and back down the ice. And Redden back first.
So Ken Hitchcock juggling up a few formations there at the forward position there. Now it's Andy McDonald there with Steen and Tarasenko. And that's, of course, the line that we started the NHL season with. They were on fire. McDonald, Steen, and Tarasenko. So now we've got Sobotka on the same line here with David Backes and TJ Oshie. There's Andy McDonald, head down, frustrated. Frustrated group that's got to quickly react. One thing about this league, nobody feels sorry for you in the National Hockey League.
You think the Red Wings will feel sorry for the Blues on Wednesday?
Got to pick it up.
Everything just seems heavier when things are not going well. Your body doesn't feel good. Obviously, your mind doesn't. And you can see just kind of like the body language with the heads down. It's very difficult. But as you said, the only one way you get out of it, and that's by keep working hard.
And Ellerby gets it in off the glass. Now it's Nolan to Richards. A high shot. And Elliott goes down and makes that save, maybe off the mask.
That stung him. A lot of times it'll hit your mask and then carom right down, and it's almost the only time that it exposes like your collarbone and your throat area. But that stung him for sure. No rebound whatsoever. Wicked wrist shot by Richards, and clearly off the right side of his mask and shoulder collarbone area right there. And that might leave a welt.
And the final 25 seconds here tonight. It's Sobotka. Snaps a shot and a save by Bernier. And again, no further play. Now Sobotka and Drewski having words.
I think Sobotka's played with his heart on his sleeve as much as anybody in this game. That's with the puck, that's battling for loose pucks, that's fighting your own battles as he did at the end of the second period, taking exception to that hit by Lewis and the boards. He's a gamer.
Yeah, you thought that fight might turn the momentum around. It did for a while, but the Kings have done a good job protecting their big lead. And 10 seconds left here. Blues will fall to 6-5-1. The Kings will go to 4-5-2. And at the horn, they congratulate Bernier's first win of the year. The Kings win it 4-1.
His last game was in relief, February 2nd at Anaheim. Not an easy position to be in, but after Jonathan Quick struggled with that late goal yesterday afternoon, Bernier gets the nod, not heavily tested, but a terrific team win by the LA Kings. They were good.
And Pat Parris, the Blues' winless streak is 0-4-1. That's tough to take.
Certainly is. John Kelly, in fact, outscored 26-11 during this five-game winless streak. Certainly not Blues hockey that we thought we'd see during this 2013 season. The LA Kings, after that slow start, played well yesterday in Detroit and came up just short, but tonight they were the more physical hockey team. They were the better hockey team for 60 minutes, and they go away with the 4-1 win to the Kings over the Blues. Don't forget, it's the Missouri Lottery of Blues Live post-game show. It'll be coming up a bit later on, and Andy McDonald, you can see the frustration on the Blues. Stay with us.